Good morning, students. Kailash Chandra Panda welcomes you to his English environment. Today, I have come with a new topic from your English grammar, that is subject-verb agreement. Be concentrated on the video. You know, students, sentence is a family of words. Can you say what are the most important elements of a family? You must say they are husband and wife. And they must agree to most of the points for the smooth running of the family. If sentence is a family of words, its important elements will be subject and verb. Subject is regarded as the husband of the sentence family and verb is the wife. And if they do not agree with each other, the sentence will be grammatically incorrect. So before coming to the point of agreement, let's know first what subject is. The person, place or idea that the sentence is about is called subject. The verb tells what the subject does or is, or links the subject to another word that describes it. Action verb shows action subject performs. For example, he plays football. And linking verb connects subject to another word or words that describes it. For example, Ramu is a boy. Helping verbs join an action verb to form the complete verb. Ramo is playing in the field. Let's know what is subject-verb agreement. Subject-verb agreement means our subject and verb must match or agree to person and number. A singular subject must take a singular verb and a plural subject must take a plural verb. For example, the boy goes to school at 10 a.m. The boys go to school at 10 a.m. Here, the boy is singular, so it takes the verb goes. But the boys, that is plural, so the verb is plural and go. I am a farmer. You are a farmer. He is a farmer. Here see one thing, the verb agrees with the person of the subject. But students, sometimes we mistake the singular subject and plural subject as other. That is why rules are needed. Let's now discuss the rules. If a sentence starts with a dummy subject, the verb will follow the real subject that comes after the verb. For example, there is a pen in the bag. There are two pens in the bag. Here in the first sentence, a pen is the main subject and it is singular. So the verb is also singular. But in the second sentence, two pens, it is plural. So it takes the verb are. Now come to the second rule. If the sentence starts with the pronoun it, the verb will always be singular. For example, it is 10:30, it is raining heavily, etc. If it acts as a dummy subject in the sentence, the verb will follow the real subject. For example, it is I who am to be blamed, but it is you who are to be blamed. It is Ramo who is to be blamed. When two or more nouns represents a compound name of one thing or one person, the compound is thought to be singular and takes a singular verb. For example, bread and butter is my favorite breakfast. Truth and honesty is the best policy. Slow and steady wins the race. But when they refer to different things or persons, the verb become plural. For example, fish and meat are rich food. Time and tide wait for none. When plural subjects refer to distance, weight, height or amount of money and stand for a single unit of quantity, they are considered as singular and they always take a singular verb. For example, 10 kilometers is a long distance for me to work. 2 kilos of sugar costs 80 rupees. Some collective nouns such as government, committee, family take a plural verb when they refer to individual members separately. They can take a singular verb when they mean a group as a single body. For example, the government have kept their election promise. Here government means individual ministers. So it takes plural verb. Now the government welcomes the proposal. It is as a whole. The committee are against the appointment. Here committee indicates individual members. But the committee was unanimous on this issue. Here the committee is regarded as a single body. Some nouns like police, poultry, cattle, people, sheep usually take plural verbs as they are considered as plural. For example, the police have not made any arrest. The cattle are grazing in the field. The poultry have been fed. But students, if the phrases like a congregation of, a group of, a folk of, a head of, a crowd of are added with the nouns before them, they take a singular verb. For example, a group of people was standing at the gate. A flock of sheep is grazing in the field. A herd of cattle was sleeping under the tree. The noun like food, clothing, furniture, stationery, cutlery, crockery, jewelry, scenery usually take a singular verb as they are considered as uncountable noun. For example, his clothing is very attractive. Food is necessary for living. The furniture needs to be repaired. Some count nouns which consist of two parts are regarded as plural and take a plural verb. They are trousers, scissors, shoes, glasses, pincers, binoculars, pyjamas, shorts, stockings, spectacles, etc. For example, your trousers are dirty. Those scissors belong to me. Her shoes are black. But if the phrase a pair of is used before the nouns, they take singular verb. For example, a pair of scissors belongs to me. A pair of trousers cost 400 rupees. A new pair of shoes was given to me. If a clause separates the subject from the verb, it is necessary to remember the actual subject word to make the verb agree with it. For example, the book you have given me is very nice. But here, the books you have given me are very nice. If a subject begins with either of, neither of, one of, no one of, each of, followed by a plural noun or pronoun, the verb will always be singular. For example, either of the boys has got a prize. Neither of them has come. Each of the students was given a dictionary. If no or some is used, followed by a noun, the verb will follow the real noun. For example, no child has done his homework, but no children have done their homework. Some water is left in the pot. Some girls have gone on a picnic. Students, next time we will see the other rules of subject-verb agreement. See you soon. Stay blessed.